Hello, hello, everybody. Welcome back to another time lapse here on my channel. This one is for Kitagawa Marin from, I always forget the name of the series, Dress Up Darling is the English title. I'm actually not a huge fan of this series, but I really like her design. The main heroine, the main girl's design. I had an idea for a scene here of kind of like a hot summer day where she's kind of waiting in the heat and kind of like sitting under the shade of a tree is the idea for this one. And I felt like I needed to have like a gal kind of character. I thought it would work better with that sort of thing. So I thought I may as well just draw her, right? I like doing fan art. Even if I don't really like the series, I like her design, right? So that's good enough for me. You notice I was really struggling with the figure. I kind of redrew it 3 or 4 times and I kind of get it down more or less here, but you'll notice it looks a little tight in the middle. This is before, I drew this like 3 weeks ago or something. I'm really behind on my time lapses, hey? But when I finished this drawing, I practiced foreshortening, kind of the body. And mainly, like, I'm okay with drawing arms and legs foreshortened. Like, I kind of understand that, but when it comes to drawing, like, the central body mass, like the torso and the pelvis and kind of the belly area foreshortened is really difficult, so I had the idea of kind of looking down at this character kind of sitting, and she's holding a water bottle to her neck because it's really hot, sitting under the shade of like a tree in the park waiting for somebody. That's the idea for this one. So I'm kind of tidying up the figure here a little bit, but it still looks really tight. And eventually, once I get to it, I think I do it on day 2. This took me, I think, 5 days total, 4 or 5 days, about 2 hours each, so. Once I get to day 2, you'll notice that I actually, what I did is I pulled up a 3D model that Clip Studio has. I don't know if I include it in this video or if I did it off stream, I can't remember. But I wound up tracing over it. I kind of recreated the sitting pose that I had here, and then I kind of traced over to kind of see if I could correct the issues that I had. And then I kind of altered it a little bit from there, so you'll see that sooner or later. What else do I want to talk about? Oh, the floor. The most fun I had with this one was actually drawing the floor. There's kind of like a tiled, I guess it's not the floor, right? It's like the, do you call it the floor? I feel like the floor is like inside of a building. I don't know. The ground, you know, the ground of the park. I did kind of a cool tile thing and it was really fun. There was a number of things I struggled with this one. The main one was the foreshortening. I also really struggled with the hair, kind of mainly in like the line art phase, trying to make it look clean and nice. So you'll see that in a little bit too. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I want to touch on. I went a little overboard with the final effects. This will be near the end of the time lapse. You can look forward to that. Too much lighting. I wanted it to feel like a hot day, you know, like really hot sunlight, kind of shining beams of light, kind of shining through the tree that's above her. So I was like, how do I do that? I want to make it really look like a hot day, you know? And I think I went a little overboard, but it was fun. It was really fun. I like working with effects. I don't do it enough. So yeah, I think here I'm just touching up the figure. And then after this, I trace over it, over the 3D model. So I usually like to try and do everything myself, but I'm not against tracing, you know? As long as you set it up yourself, right? You're not tracing somebody else's work. I don't think it really matters. There's kind of this weird thing in my brain where I feel like I need to do it all manually myself, you know? It's more fun that way. I think it's more rewarding. Maybe that's what it is. But either way, just trying to think if there's anything else. Probably not. So I'll stop yippity-yapping, hey? Thanks for watching, everybody, as always. This one was a lot of fun. It was honestly like when I was drawing the floor, I had like an epiphany, like, wow, you know, like another realization of how fun drawing can be. Drawing floor. Can you believe that? I don't know. It's weird. You don't really realize how fun drawing certain things are until you try it, you know, like tessellations kind of things. Like when I was drawing the pattern of the floor tiles, you'll see when I get there, but it's kind of satisfying kind of drawing repeating cubes and squares, or not cubes, rectangles along the floor. It was really fun. I'm probably overstating how fun it was. I just don't know what to say in these time lapses, so I'll shut up. So thanks again, everybody. And yeah, enjoy the rest of the video. And I'll catch you next time, eh? Take care, everybody. Thanks for watching, and Happy New Year, eh? Happy New Year, everybody. I drew this December of last year, but whatever. Happy New Year. I'll say it a few more times just to be safe. Happy New Year. Happy New Year, okay. I'm gonna go now. I don't even know what I'm talking about anymore. Goodbye. Whoa, 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 whoa.